Dear viewers, this video is mainly for the learners of IGNO enrolled for the July 2020 session under IGNO Regional Center Kochi. This video gives glimpses of how to study at distance at IGNO. The video also gives certain salient features like the facts about Regional Center Kochi, facilities to the learners at learner support centers, submission of continuous assessment like project report, assignments, facilities to the learners at IGNO Regional Center and the website of IGNO Regional Center Kochi, availability of study materials, assignments, evaluation and conduct of examination at IGNO, scholarship, guidelines for a learners to remember. Now viewers, we will have a look at what learning at distance means to you as a learner. Over to Dr. J.S. Dorothy, Regional Director, IGNO Regional Center Kochi.
Friends, we welcome you to this induction meeting once again to just to share about what is open and distance learning system. All of you will be engaged in other activities at family commitments, social commitments, job commitments, and also personal commitments. And some of you will be having challenging health conditions also. But amidst all these conditions, you have come to study, which means your studying or continuing education has a purpose. And this open and distance learning system is so flexible that it can accommodate you to facilitate the learning process amidst all your commitments. But you should remember three things. One is you are away from your colleagues or the peers who's enrolled for the same program of study. You are away from the distance teaching institution, that is IGNO in this case, and you are also away from the person who wrote the study material. So what is the bridge between all these constraints and your necessity for education? It is the learner support center. So you should know what is your learner support center. And regional center is only like a booking station, I should say, booking office where you reserve your tickets. Whereas your learner support center is the platform in the particular station where you will board on to your train. So you should know your learner support center, and also you should know who is heading that learner support center, and you should always know what activities you have to do. And in addition, amidst all the activities or the facilities available in the learner support center, if you are unaware whether your interest or your need is met, you have to express your interest. So who will be the right person to contact at the learner support center? It is the coordinator. Friends, one more thing you should remember. Distance learning is more like a small monkey clinging to the mother monkey. In other words, we won't come after you like the mother cat taking care of the small kitten. Why? Because we think that you are an adult learner and you know of what you have to prioritize in your life, whether it is your personal commitment, it's your job commitment, or your family commitment, or your social commitment, or the purpose of study. So that's why in IGNO also we have a minimum duration and a maximum duration. And for your kind information, there's no readmission period beyond the maximum period. In other words, the maximum period cannot be extended further. So certain skills you have to inculcate when you are studying with IGNO, that we will look at it under the section of life skills management, which will come after some point of time once again, because first you need to get accustomed to what is the purpose of study and how you can ensure that the access to the study will lead to completion of the program. So friends, what did I say now? Open and distance learning system will be a student friendly system and will help you to study amidst your commitments in any sense. And then second is, there is a minimum prescribed period and a maximum prescribed period given by the open distance learning system so that your access into the program of study can lead to the successful completion of the program. The third point which I told was, you have to be in touch with the learner support center, because all student related activities for academic transaction and also the evaluation process, the cert which leads to certification, are done at Learner Support Center. And you need not always come physically. You can be in touch. The safest and the best way to be in touch with regional center and the Learner Support Center is the email ID, by means of the using the email contacts. We display it in the website also for your use. And the last point which I told is, it is your responsibility to come after the process which are available and which will cater to all the heterogeneous population which we have. Why? Because you are away from the distance teaching institution, you are away from the peers who have enrolled for the program, and you are also away from the person who wrote the study material. So friends, starting to study itself is the first and the best part you have done in the acquiring of education qualification. The next is to sustain the interest till you complete the program of study. Thank you friends for listening.
Viewers, you will agree with me that learning at distance is depend on you as an individual, and the role of Learner Support Center is equally important for you for the successful completion of the program. Having understood the meaning of learning through distance and your commitment for study as an independent learner, have you ever wondered who is backing up all the back office operations? Well friends, this is the regional center. Dr. L. Chandrasekharan will share all the facilities available at the Learner Support Centers, and sir will also speak about the Regional Center website.
IGNU Regional Center Cochin is located in a prominent and convenient location of Ernakulam city, and it is very near to Metro Rail, private bus stand and other railway stations in Ernakulam. IGNU Regional Center has the best infrastructure facilities when compared to other regional centers across the country. And this open and distance learning system, the learners are communicated through SMS and email mostly. For detailed information, learners are advised to visit IGNU website, and they can visit IGNU site at www.ignu.ac.in. And Regional Center Cochin's website at rccochin.ignu.ac.in. So learners can visit IGNU website as frequently as possible to get the updated information regarding their studies. So in our system, the learners are identified by their enrollment number. To avail any online services, student has to use their enrollment number. So it is very important to remember that, and program code also. In open and distance learning system, the learners are being communicated through SMS, WhatsApp, email, Twitter and so on. However, for detailed information, they can access our university's website at ignu.ac.in, where students can re-register, submit examination through online. So apart from this, students can see their status regarding re-registration, dispatch of study materials, examination results, assignment grades, etc. And also, the learners can download previous question papers, assignment question papers and study materials, soft copy of the study material, and many other things are available in the IGNU website. Students can visit student zone, where they can get oriented about many aspects of their learning for their successful completion of the program. And learners of this region, that is Cochin Regional Center, they can visit IGNU Regional Center Cochin's website at www.rccochin.ignu.ac.in. where the regional center has uploaded the induction guidelines, and you can download the guidelines and go through nicely so that you will get to know what to do next. This induction guidelines gives a great detail about whom to contact for what at Regional Center Cochin as well as our headquarters at New Delhi for various services to be available by the learners. And for whatever services they require. And further, Regional Center Cochin website contains newsletter, brochures of various programs and activities of this Regional Center, which will be beneficial to the learners. Learners can visit IGNU Regional Center Cochin website for all their requirements as well as to know the various academic activities happening in the Regional Center. The induction guidelines, I would like to add further to that. The induction guidelines has the email IDs and phone numbers of officials or sections dealing with particular subject are given in the guidelines, which can be beneficial to all the learners for their requirements.
Dear learners, now are you sure who is backing up your studies? Yes friends, this is the Regional Center. But remember that all the academic transactions are only at learner support centers. Each LSC has its own code. For example, Sacred Heart College, Thevara, the study center code will be 1402. And Nirmala College, Mayapura, 14127. Now it's time to listen, Dr. Janajakumari VT, Assistant Regional Director of RC Kochi. Madam will talk about assignments, online counseling schedules, submission of project reports, etc.
Dear learners, our heartfelt welcome to the new learners of IGNU who have enrolled for July 2020 session. We are communicating with you from Regional Center Cochin. Now you are the students of Regional Center Cochin, IGNU, with a 10-digit enrollment number. After confirming your admission, all of you have received one enrollment number, and that is the identity of you, that you are IGNU learners. So you may keep this enrollment number with you till the end of your learning with IGNU. So let me tell you one thing, you can keep a file exclusively for IGNU learning and IGNU program. This may be the first document you are going to keep in this IGNU file. Now, you remember your enrollment number is starting with 20. That denotes that you are the learners of 2020. Okay. Now, what you are expecting from us immediately after getting your admission? Definitely, it will be your learning materials. Your study materials. We call it SLM, self-learning material. By the name itself, you can understand what will be the role of the study material and what will be your role to deal with that study material. So you have to be that much responsible to learn your study material yourself. But you don't think that we are not at all helping you. We are helping. I think most of you have received your study materials. The students who have taken their admission earlier, they got. The others will be getting soon. So you don't worry about it. And now I am going to tell you about how the study material is facilitating you, or how we are going to facilitate you by utilizing this study materials. That is what called in IGNU academic counseling. So it is a little bit different than of teaching. The name itself is counseling, not teaching. So students will get face-to-face contact sessions in IGNU. You know that ours is an open university, and as per the university norms, only I think almost 10% of the classes will be given to you on face-to-face mode. Academic counseling sessions are given at the LSCs. LSCs means Learner Support Centers. So the academic counselors who are empaneled as subject experts from IGNOU are giving you all the support services regarding academic counseling. So whenever you are getting your study materials, you may please go through that and be familiar with the content, the terminologies given, and the whole syllabus. Then with that familiarity, you have to come to the classes. Then it will be easier for the academic counselor to interact with you, because we cannot complete the syllabus as such. But if you are asking some questions, if you are conveying your difficulties to the academic counselor, definitely the academic counselor can help you by giving the needed information, descriptions, explanations, and all. So that is what academic counseling. So the material is the instrument there. You go through that, come to the contact classes, get the information from the academic counselor. All our academic counselors are subject experts who are working in the regular system, in the regular colleges, as per UGC norms and eligibility criteria. So now you will be well versed with your content matters, and you are getting ready to face the examinations. So again, one strategy is there. That strategy is an internal assessment strategy that is called assignment. You know, in our school time onwards, we were facing many, many assignments. And when we are writing and preparing for assignments, that will also be a strategy for good learning. The assignment questions for IGNOU learners will be available in the IGNOU website. All of you are familiar with the IGNOU website because you have taken your admission online. Next to the online link, there is a link that is student support. In that, student zone is there. Student zone. Click on that and enter to the assignment link, where all the assignments needed for your session will be uploaded. And it is there. It is ready there. You can download the questions by clicking on the programs and again on the concerned courses you want to have to write your assignment. Download it, keep it with you, prepare your assignments. And you can submit your assignments in your study centers. That is Learner Support Centers, LSCs. Your assignments have to be submitted in handwritten. And IGNOU is not allowing any learner to submit assignment in typed form or copied from internet or some other places. So it is to be noted specifically that you have to submit your assignment in handwritten form, and it is having some additional inputs like its facing sheet, a receipt, and everything. This information will be you will be getting from your LSC when you are going there for submission. You know, we all are going through this COVID-19 pandemic situation. Hence, IGNOU is providing the facility for submitting your assignment and projects in online mode. IGNOU Regional Center Cochin's website is providing you the link for submission of assignments. Why I am telling at first itself, the semester learners of BCA, MCA, MBA all have to submit their assignment soon. So they can submit their assignment through this online link given in the student corner of IGNOU Regional Center website. You know the website ID? It is rccochin.ignou.ac.in. There you will be getting, it is there already, it is uploaded there, and you can see the link for submission of assignment. And you have to focus on assignment very carefully. Why? Because it is the part of an internal assessment. And when the grade card is prepared, the weightage for assignment is given as 30%, and the rest of the 70% is from term and examination. So is equally important. Weightage will be more in examination, even though you have to focus on assignment, because peacefully You can write your assignments by referring your study materials and some other books, and you will get easily that 30%. So, see the importance of assignment and write as such and submit in the learner support centers. So, assignments have to be submitted in your concerned LSEs in written form with all the formalities. Formalities means the facing sheet, one receipt is attached there. If once it is submitted, you may have to keep the proof of your submission. Otherwise, sometimes if the study center is telling that you have not submitted your assignment, proof should be there with you to show at what time, on which day you have submitted. So for that purpose, the counterfoil of the receipt should be kept in your IGNO file. I told you about the file. Now, another strategy is there to assess your learning process, your learning achievement. That is what? Projects, internship, other practicums, etc. You don't think that all students, means all programs have these projects, internship, practicums. No. Projects and internship and practicums are given for some programs only. Especially projects are for PG programs. Besides, some bachelor degree programs like BTS, BAPC, that is BA Psychology program, BA Library Science, BSW, these programs may have practicums and some project works, mini project works. BCA is also having. So almost all project postgraduate degrees may have projects. Project submission is a compulsory part of that particular programs, and prior to the submission of the projects, you have to prepare some synopsis. Then you have to get the approval from the concerned academic counselor or guide. Then you have to submit the final project report. So all the program is having a program guide, and the syllabus, the works you have to go through, everything is given in that. Go through the program guide and find out the activities you have to be engaged with. So, postgraduate programs having projects have another handbook course, project handbook course. So you will get the project handbook. Sometimes it is called as project manual. You will get the project handbook or the project manual along with your study materials, and you can refer that for the processes of preparation of synopsis and project. Mainly in the second year only, students may have project works. So you don't worry about it. In the first year or in the first semester, as usual, you can go through the theory works. If any practical work, that works. And you can concentrate on the project, internship, practicum works in the second year. These are the main things you have to concentrate on while starting your learning with IGNO. First thing, once again I will summarize. First is, you will get the study materials and attend the counseling sessions. I have to tell you one thing as a major point. For theory papers, attending counseling sessions is not a compulsory part. But for practicals, it is 100% compulsory. That means you have to attend the practical sessions in 100% attendance. Otherwise, you cannot write the practical examinations. So, once again, I'll focus on there will be face-to-face sessions in theory and practical. But theory part is not a compulsory part. If you are able to learn your study material or your program without the help of any academic counselor, you can. No problem. But if you want to have the study materials to be explained or clarified by the academic counselor, you have to attend the counseling sessions. Then you write your assignment, submit it in the LSE, then you will be okay for registration for examination, and you can proceed your learning in IGNO. So the rest of the things will be explained by my colleagues.
Viewers, you are listening to Dr. Janajakumari BT, Assistant Regional Director of IGNO Regional Center Kochi, sharing about submission of assignments, project reports, online counseling schedules. Dear learners, you will agree with me that most of the academic transactions happens only at learner support centers. Certain administrative functions like change of regional center, learner support center, and examination center happens at regional center only. Learners, did you observe that the guidelines for learners? Schedule for Gyanvani and Gyantarshan, link for examination form submission are available at regional center website. Friends, now let us know from Mr. K.K. Joseph, Assistant Registrar of Regional Center Kochi, about the study materials which the learners get.
The study material is provided to all students who takes admission. There are two options for getting the study materials. Those who want only soft copy of the study material, they can give options for the same. They will be provided 15% of concession from the program fee. Those who want print material, they can opt for the same also. They have to pay the full fee. For them, study materials are dispatched to their address from Material Production and Distribution Division. If the study materials are not received by the students in their address, it will be returned to the regional center. And after that, regional center will send SMS to collect the study materials. And if they are not collecting study materials within 1 week, it will be sent back to Delhi. So students are requested to be careful that they attend the SMS messages and accordingly collect the materials. IGNO study material is called SIM, that is self-instructional material. The study material is prepared so as to give necessary instruction to the student how to proceed with their study. For each program of study, there are number of courses, and each course is divided into different books of blocks, such as block 1, block 2, etc. Each book divided into different units or chapters. At the end of each unit, there will be questions for checking your progress. Those who want soft copy of study materials, they can download it from eGyankosh, for which a link is provided in the IGNO website. Students can also download study materials from the IGNO eConnect app from Google Play Store. Students can also view the status of study material dispatch from the IGNO website. The students attached to RC Campus Study Center may be asked to collect the study materials from the regional center, for which they will be given SMS giving the dates for collection of the materials.
To give an idea about scholarship schemes available for IGNO learners, Sri K.J. Joseph, Section Officer of RC Kochi, will be speaking on scholarships.
Well, for the SC/ST students seeking admission for various programs, benefits of the FIA, exemption or reimbursements are available in two streams in IGNO. Stream number 1, University Direct Benefit Scheme. This scheme is only in the academic program given in the separate annexer given in the prospectus. Conditions are applying for these benefits are students who are eligible to wish avail these benefits of fee exemption shall submit their application in online mode itself with their soft copy of documents for caste and income certificates. Second conditions are at the time of only one program shall be eligible for the fee exemption. Third condition, this scheme shall not be available to the enrolled applicants. Fourth condition, students who are taking the benefits of fee exemption or reimbursement from any other source or agency is not eligible for fee exemption of IGNO programs. An undertaking in this, on this behalf has to be submitted by on return at the time of registration in online mode. The second scheme is State Government's Welfare Board Reimbursement Scheme. The scheme is restricted for undergraduate programs and postgraduate programs only. The conditions are students who are eligible to wish avail these benefits of fee reimbursement from SC/ST Welfare Board shall submit a separate application from separate application form along with all educational, caste and income certificate to the regional director after the confirmation of admission registration through online mode. Second condition is enrolled applicants shall not be eligible for these benefits. Third condition, at a time of only one program shall be eligible for reimbursement. The fourth condition, students who are taking the benefits So reimbursement from any other source or agency shall not be eligible for free reimbursement from state welfare board. Fifth condition, undertaking has to be submitted by the candidates in this regard, stating that no benefit of this kind of from any other agency or source during the period of study is to be taken along with the application. The approval or the rejection of the claim depend on the SCST secretariat of the government body. This is the SCST welfare, SCST reimbursement scheme available in IGNOU. Thank you.
Learners, did you listen that e-content of study material is available at eGyan Ghosh? The study material's content is enough to do the assignments and write the examination of IGNOU. But learners, do you have any idea about how to appear for the examination? Now here we have Dr. S. Vijayarakhavan, Assistant Regional Director of IGNOU Regional Center Kochi. He will talk about the conduct of examination and convocation at IGNOU.
Dear learner, we welcome you all as a IGNOU learner in the academic session July 2020. So this induction meeting we are conducting through virtual mode. I am going to talk about examination and convocation related matters. So examination, we can see that the examination is being conducted annually two times, June term end examination and December term end examination. We have activated around 13 examination center under RC Cochin, which is very useful for the Cochin regional center learners. And the following district we have examination centers: Ernakulam, Thrissur, Idukki and Lakshadweep, ILACS. Assignments need to be submitted per course or assignment before attending term end examination. Assignment need to be handwritten. It should be submitted to the concerned LSC. Due to the COVID-19 situation, to follow the social distance to avoid infection, we have introduced a link for assignment soft copy submission through Google link. For previous June 2019 session and also the present December 2020 also, the soft copy of the assignment the candidate can able to submit through the Google form. If the candidate ready to submit the hard copy of the assignment, then the candidate can able to submit the hard copy assignment at the LSC concern, which is following the standard procedure for COVID-19. Examination form submission through online mode. The last date for term end examination December 2020 has been extended up to 15 December 2020, and the examination will be held on first week of February 2021. Fee for the theory course registration is 150, and also practical also that examination registration per course is 150 rupees. The semester based on the certificate program candidate, they can able to write the examination in the month of February 2021. The answer to write the question paper will be only accepted in the language which is the program is in offered. However, the student have option to attempt the examination of the course in Hindi medium irrespective of the registration of the same in the English medium, except of language programs. The convocation we are conducting at IGNOU Regional Center Kochi, the eligible candidate we are communicating through the SMS, and also the candidate able to get the information from the IGNOU website also. The eligible candidate, they can be able to receive the degree certificate in the convocation ceremony which is held at the IGNOU Regional Center of Kochi. If suppose the candidate unable to attend the convocation, their degree will be available at the IGNOU Regional Center of Kochi. In absence here, they can be able to get it from the RC Kochi. Thank you very much.
Learners, you have traveled with us from studying at distance to conduct of examinations. Now, Dr. Prasida Unnikrishnan, Assistant Director of RC Cochin, will summarize the sessions you have heard so far and present the same as a checklist.
Dear learners, first of all, let me share with you some of the important points as a checklist to you to enable you complete your program successfully from IGNO. First and foremost, remember your 10-digit enrollment number, your program code, and your course codes. After that, please check your registration details by logging on to the student zone of IGNO website www.igno.ac.in. Please check the minimum and maximum duration of your program. Also, check your name, address, and email address for any corrections in the same. You may please write to rckochin@igno.ac.in. In case the registration details are not available, please contact IGNO Regional Center Cochin at rckochin@igno.ac.in. Normally, registration details are available on the IGNO website after the admission process gets completed. Secondly, your ID card is the most important document and should be maintained throughout your completion of your program from IGNO. Please download your ID card from the admission portal by using your username and password. Your ID card is very essential when you write your term and examinations, while attending your Project Viva, etc., and for any communication related to the regional center and LSE, the ID card is a very important document. Your study materials include your self-learning materials, program guide, and in case your program of study has a fieldwork or a project component, it will also include your fieldwork manual and project guidelines. So please go through the program guide thoroughly, as the program guide provides you vital information about the program of your study and would enable you to complete your program successfully from IGNO. Next, remember the name of your study center, the study center code, and the study center address. Since academic counseling sessions are being provided by the study centers, it is important that you note down all the contact details of the study center staff and the study center. Academic counseling sessions are presently being provided in online virtual mode due to the present pandemic situation. So for further details onto the same, you all should contact your study center. Next is, the change of electives is not possible for students who are pursuing BA, BCom and BSc program. This is a very important information, as many as times students do come to us for change of course. It's again informed, change of course is not possible for students studying in BA, BCom and BSc program under CBCS. Further, while writing assignments, as it has already been mentioned by my other colleagues, assignments have to be handwritten and need to be submitted at your LSE only. But however, due to the current pandemic situation, assignments can be also submitted through the online mode with the link which is available on the RC Cochin website. Assignment questions can be downloaded from the student zone of IGNO website. Examinations. The next is examinations. For examinations, you also need to apply online, even for the theory and practical courses, the link of which will also be available on the IGNO website www.igno.ac.in. Another vital information which I would like to give you is, please download the old question papers from the IGNO website under student zone, and please go through the old question papers, as this will give you an idea about the questions which are usually being asked under your program of study. Once you complete your grade card from IGNO, the provisional certificate and the mark sheet is generally dispatched by the Student Evaluation Division of IGNO headquartered Delhi. Lastly, I would also like to mention that we have already uploaded a 9-page induction guideline booklet on the regional Center Cochin website www.rccochin.igno.ac.in. The link has already been sent as an SMS to you all. Request you all to go through this 9-page induction guidelines booklet, as this will again provide you with various information what has just been informed through this video also on how to complete your program successfully from IGNO. Lastly, I would just like to highlight, for any queries pertaining to your program of study, please feel free to contact us at our RC Cochin email ID, rccochin@igno.ac.in, or you can put in your query through iGram at www.igram.igno.ac.in. Lastly, I would just like to conclude by saying that IGNO means self-motivation. Dear learners, you have to be self-motivated to successfully complete your program, and wishing you all the best in your successful completion of the program. Thank you.
Friends, many at times you may not be sure of what you got to do for the successful completion of the program as you does life education skills. It is your right to access education, but do you know that many factors from within you needs to be exhibited to access education leads to successful completion of the program you have enrolled? Let me be honest to state that all life education skills cannot be documented at one go during this induction meeting video. However, salient features have necessarily been shared with you by Dr. J.S. Dorothy, Regional Director of IGNO Regional Center, Cochin. Over to Dr. J.S. Dorothy.
Friends, what is life skill education? What is life, you know? What is skill, you know? What is education also, you know? But putting all the three things in one point of time in our life is life skill education. So, what are the things you need to ensure that the skills you learned, which were taught, which were caught by you, and also the education which you have earned so far in life, can be put to enhance the quality of your life, is called life skill education. So what you have to do as a distance learner when you are studying with IGNO to ensure that your life skill is developed and nurtured? First is the time management. We know always we have only 24 hours, but still we have to manage so many commitments besides our studying process. So we always encourage you that you fulfill the prerequisites which are prescribed in the time schedule. In other words, the prerequisites will only help you to lead to the successful completion of the program, because prerequisites are like law. It cannot be revisited after the deadline. So, fulfill the prerequisites. What is the example of one prerequisite related to your study with IGNO? Is the submission of assignment. So suppose today is the last date for submission of assignment and you are unable to submit it, please send one request letter at least to the coordinator telling your situation of why you are unable to submit it, and earn some 2 or 3 days grace time to submit the same. Similarly, for examination, there is one deadline to submit the examination form. Sometimes in life, no, we always think after 2 months what will happen, and we fail to think of what we have to do today. So that is one example we always encounter with the submission of examination form. What generally the students told was, my boss was telling that he will be shuffling me, or my in-laws, they were about to visit me, so I did not fill the form. Now they are not visiting, I am not transferred, so can I write the exam? The question we ask them is, have you filled the form? When they have not filled the form, and accommodating them in the specific examination center will be very difficult. So what I encourage you, friend, please fulfill the prerequisites. Especially when it is computerized and online, we cannot exercise the element of discretion to extend that time beyond the deadline set. So time management is very important. And keep track of what you have done and what you have to do. Meaning, keep a diary. So in other words, what are the assignments you have submitted, what you have to submit in future, and when you are going to do. So it's all linked with the time management, which you have to do it in the first instance. Many a time when we are uploading, now during this pandemic situation, we are facilitating the learners to upload the soft copy of the assignment. It is interesting to share that the students error which should not happen in your life. That's why I'm sharing, even though it relates to the error of a learner. So what happens is, sometimes they write the assignment, they upload the same assignment response for the multiple courses which they have enrolled. In other words, when they have written the assignment response, they have scanned it, but when they have named it wrongly, and they have uploaded the same assignment response in the online link. So that should not happen to you, friends. So what you should know, what you have done and what you have to do. And the next sequence of the fulfilling the prerequisites, the time management. The third is the honesty of an individual. Honesty of an individual have spin-off benefits beyond your learning process at IGNU, for that matter in any life. Always, even though, for example, if you are a boss and or you are going to evolve into a boss, and there are two individuals of the same caliber, definitely you will prefer the person who is more honest to be in your team than the one who is not so good in admitting the mistakes, or somebody who is always blaming others when the mistake is on that individual. So to be honest, the first criteria is you have to take responsibility for the lapses which you have made. Many a time when we are addressing the learners, it is a mass program which happens, and the learners do not come into the picture at all when it comes to the data submitted earlier. So when you are coming to the regional center, or for that matter the learner support center, please carry your data, that is your identity card, your previous mark sheets, or your proof for having submitted the assignment response and the like, because that is what will help us to develop and solve your issue into targeting of successful completion of your program. So one more thing you should always think is, all problems will have a solution, but there is a process to find out a solution, and that is also unique to IGNU. Sometimes it will look like the problem, when it is identified, it will look like that it is so big that it cannot be solved. So when a problem is very big, try to divide it into small parts and solve it. Definitely, above all, I would encourage you, please trust in God that the problem will be solved in any matters, whether it is life or for learning. So the next item which I want to share it with life skills is persistence. Many a time we would have heard of stories that people give up in the last minute. That should not happen in your life. That's why I say, do not give up. Do not give up, I repeat it again, because it is you who have enrolled for the program. It is only you who can write the examination and fulfill all the prerequisites. No, we can only facilitate. For example, how much ever we care for you as a distance education professional, I cannot come and write examination for you. Neither I can write your assignment response. But I can tell you, there are old question papers in the website. There are the patterns of the question papers are specific for session and the like. But I cannot write examination for you. So you have to write. So you have to prioritize of what you have to do at a specific point of time, which will contribute to the persistence of the skill to be developed to ensure that the access to the program of study lead to successful completion of the program. So what is your idea related to persistence is, never give up. The next is, keep the deadlines. Even when you are, you don't mistake me otherwise, as far as IGNU is concerned, the Indian Standard Time, we call it Indian Stretchable Time. So when you are unable to fulfill the deadlines, especially when the element of discretion or consideration can be done by the coordinator or the regional center, please write an email to them expressing your situation and seek some grace time. And next, what you have to do is, sometimes we will have everything, but we will be checking all our messages, all our WhatsApp videos, but we fail to concentrate on what we have to do for studies. One more thing which is comes to learning is, friends, we can see TV and then check our mail. We can see, listen to a music and then we can talk, keep talking to somebody else. And at this, and when we are writing something or like a story, or we are copying some quotes from a newspaper to store it late for later use, we can still listen to the song from the air. But when you want to study for examination, you have to forego certain leisure time activities. It may be seeing TV, listening to music, but remember, friends, studying or acquiring an education qualification will definitely have spin-off benefits, which will reflect on your financial status, on your career status, and also in this social status. So friends, what I was talking to you so far is, one is, you have to have a time management, you have to fulfill the prerequisite, you should be persistent, and you should know what you are doing, and you should be honest enough to admit of what is your situation. The final thing is expression of your interest. Many a time we are so submissive, or sometimes we are so nurtured in such a family situation that we do not express ourselves. Even when we need some very personal item, even in our home. That's why I specifically say that expression of your interest is a life skill in itself. So what, how do you express yourself? Please ask who is the coordinator. Please ask who is in the help desk in the, if you are visiting the regional center. And please express yourself from the student point of view. And when you are expressing yourself, do not get angry. Yes, you have every right to get annoyed because your problem is not solved. And don't express negative emotions in the sense the person in the other side is listening to you for the first time. So you first you express yourself, and then the next thing is, do not assume that the other individual will understand what you forgot to tell or what you are hiding to tell. That's why I told you honesty is the best policy, as we all know, that applies even to studying. Suppose you have forgotten you to fill the examination form. Don't say I filled it and then the error message came. Admit what you have done. And then please, when you are, you should be knowing what you need. For example, sometimes water facility will be in one place, the toilet facility will be in one place. And when you come for an examination or for a counseling session for the first time, it will be very difficult for you to know the layout of the regional center or the study center. And many a time with the learner support centers or in the host institution, and there is a specific space marked for use of the learner support center. So only those facilities you have to use it. So when you express yourself to ask, don't feel shy when you are asking for to know where the toilet facility is, where the drinking water facility is. If you are a nursing mother, there are we have space to take care of your babies also. So you express yourself to the coordinator or the person in the help desk. And related to the, during the conduct of examination, you have to be really expressive to say that you need special assistance. See, we ensure, we are talking about IGNU Regional Center. We always insist that the learner should be integrated. We are inclusive. So even if any specific need learner comes, we do not seclude them, or we do not insist that they should avail of the facility. But if that specific learner expresses the interest to avail of specific needs or facility, we will be rendering the same. So friends, you have to express yourself. Many time dialogue discussion happens when we express our interest. But always you please understand that we will empathize with you and we will solve your issue. whatever issue as far as pertains to the learning process at IGNU. The last point which I want to highlight is by giving you the example of the mother cat, the kitten which I was sharing with you. We won't be coming after you, definitely, like the mother cat always taking care of that small kitten. Wherever the kitten has to go, it will be taken. No. Yeah, of course, we do send the SMS to you. We display information in the website. When we do ask you to display certain information in the mails which we send also as the signature information. But it is your initiative to be in touch with the distance teaching institution. So I will encourage you that you should be like the small monkey clinging to the mother monkey. And in this case, if I equate you with the small monkey clinging to the mother monkey can be either the coordinator or the official at the regional center. But friends, many a time the regional center you need not come to regional center to take help for academic matters or for that matter related to any support services related to evaluation. Why? Because this academic transaction and evaluation process takes place only at the learner support center. And the last is how the way to communicate also matters a lot. Many a time we are so accustomed to making a phone call, and you can understand we have around 15,000 learners, active learners in one session, including the previous and the current learners on roll. And definitely your chance of getting access over the phone will not be in the first attempt, and you have to wait for your chance. In the other ways, it is always better that you communicate with us by email. Email, what is the advantage of email? It is a record, and there is time for us to reply back. And whenever you are writing a communication, be inclusive to indicate your enrollment number, the program which you study, the registration details. Just check it in the website and see whether the registration details is updated, and you can just put a print screenshot below for us to refer to it, and also the learner support centers to which you are attached and for what issue you are contacting or rather sending this email to the specific authority. So friends, with this I will say, life skill education, you will acquire something during the study, and you also need certain things to be developed. And always remember, education is lifelong. And so what you have acquired as a life skill in the last year needs to be augmented as you progress in your age. And I will also encourage, do not give up. And always I will say, how much ever we struggle, ultimately it is the life skill or the attitude towards our life will help us to evolve as a better individual amidst our circumstances. Actually, it is always told about one small donkey which was thrown by the master into a ditch because it is no more of use. And then when the master was trying to put sand, this donkey climbed up the sand, and at the end it was on the eye-to-eye level contact with the master. The first thing it told was, "Master, I know you will rescue me." So it was so optimistic, and it never even felt that the master is doing a harm to this person. So sometimes it will look like there is competition, there is cutthroat competition, there is rat race, and sometimes you will be affected or you will be affected affecting somebody else. Always remember friends, hurdles are for to cross. And ultimately I will give you one message: life is together event, it is not one specific event. That's why I always believe that, it's my personal belief, that all things is going to work together for my good. So all things matters. Sometimes you are unable to fulfill your prerequisites of submitting assignments. Sometimes your boss has not given leave to write your examination. Sometimes you have fulfilled all your prerequisites, and on that specific day when you are coming, there is an emergency in your home, and there is some life event like closing down the life of somebody which you have to encounter, and there is emotional toil in you, and you are away from the home. So all these things will make you to evolve into a better individual and in life. At the same time, it will equip you to be engaged in the learning activity at the end. Always, friends, remember, please do not give up. And all things, irrespective of what is your situation currently, is definitely will happen for your good. But always remember, whatever we do, ultimately the Almighty God has to bless it. So I will conclude this life skill information to you with one statement, that the victory, whether it is in life or education or job, will come from the Lord. Thank you for listening, friends.
Friends, did you observe the story of the donkey and the master narrated? The question I want to ask you is, will you be so optimistic to think when your master is throwing mud on you, and you will think that it is to facilitate you to come out from the ditch? The second question is, will you have the presence of mind to jump over every heap of mud thrown at you? It is true, friends, that there is no option for your feedback and comments in this video, but this will encourage you to be in touch with us in our email ID rccoaching@ignore.ac.in. Before I end, friends, I encourage you to take one day at a time to fulfill all prerequisites of every day, irrespective of all challenges every tomorrow has in your life. Friends, always remember that to study besides your job and personal commitments, IGNO has its minimum and maximum period of study. Please be benefited from the question bank available at IGNO website. Our good wishes for the successful completion of the program you study. Thank you.